This video is about how you can use your Sony mirrorless camera as a webcam to join online meetings or to make video calls. I myself use a camera of the A6000 series, but it works the same with a full frame camera like the A7 III, and it should also work with a camera of the RX series, like the RX100 or RX0. I also use a Mac, it basically works with Windows as well, but you have to use different software for Windows. However, this video is about the setup for the Mac. And very important, you don't have to buy any additional accessories for this, and the whole solution is completely free. And the basic question is, why should you use your big Sony camera for this purpose at all? For one thing, you might have, for example, a Mac Mini, but no webcam. Apart from that, it could also be that you want to capture a special angle, which is not possible with the built-in webcam. A larger sensor also captures much more light, which is especially useful in low-light conditions. And besides that, who wouldn't want to appear in a video conference with a cinematic image with a blurry background? And in case you are new here, my name is Werner, I live in the Italian Alps, and on this channel I do filmmaking tutorials and reviews of consumer cameras. Consider subscribing if you are interested in these topics, and have fun with this video. To achieve our goal, you will need two programs, Sony Remote, which is part of the Sony Imaging Edge desktop software, and CamTwist, a software that manages video sources. Both programs are free, and don't worry, the setup is quick and easy. You can find download links for both programs in the video description. Once you have downloaded and installed both programs, you need to connect your Sony camera to your computer. However, before we connect our camera to the computer, we need to change a setting on the camera. In the setup menu of your camera, you select USB connection and set it to PC remote. When you have done this, you can connect your camera. For this, we use a micro USB cable. Ideally the cable that came with the camera. You can't use every cable for this, because there are also micro USB cables that are only designed for charging devices, not for transferring data. But another data cable will do it as well, of course. Now you start the app remote. According to Sony, all current cameras are compatible with the app. As you can see here in the app, I use the relatively old Sony A6300 today. If your camera doesn't appear here, it's probably because of the cable or a wrong setting on your camera. Now double click on the camera and you will see the camera image. If the screen remains black and the live image does not appear, it is probably because you have set your camera to movie mode. So you should select a photo mode, for example the manual mode, before activating the live image. The amazing thing now is that you can manually adjust all exposure settings here. You can rotate the image, for example if you prefer to shoot vertically, and you can change the aspect ratio. You can even see a histogram. If you want, you can now also switch to the movie mode. There are no problems with overheating in this live view mode, and the battery life is quite good. After all, the camera is connected to the Mac. Two words about the autofocus. At least with my camera, the continuous autofocus doesn't work as usual, but that's no problem. When you activate the AF button in remote, the camera focuses. Then you can deactivate the button again if you want to make further adjustments. On my camera, I also switch to manual focus directly on the camera. If I want, I can now even refocus manually on the lens. In case you are interested in which lenses and other accessories I use, I've put some links in the video description. When I'm satisfied with my image, I start CamTwist. You can also do a lot with CamTwist, and it is really easy to use, even if it may seem a bit confusing at first. But for now, we want to turn a live image into a webcam. CamTwist creates a kind of virtual camera image and is later recognized as a camera source by the video conference software. If you select in the menu of CamTwist under View the preview, you can see how the current virtual video image looks like. Black. Simply because we have not yet told CamTwist what our video image should consist of. Our video image should be the live view image of the remote app. We do this using Desktop Plus by double clicking on it. In the preview image of CamTwist, you can see that our desktop appears, but the whole desktop. We do not want that, so we select Confined to Application Window, and there we select Remote, the opened window of the remote app. We don't really like that either, since we only want to stream the video image. So we select Resizable Selection and select Capture Area. Now you can set the desired capture area. But I wouldn't crop into the image too much here. This leads to a decrease of the image quality. It is better if you set the lens correctly. In the preview window, you can see if the webcam is actually set correctly. With effects, you can now also add various effects. There are gadgets like the matrix effects, or useful things like the possibility to add text. You can also use the picture-in-picture feature to combine different sources. When we now start, for example, Google Meet or Microsoft Teams, CamTwist should already be recognized as our default webcam in most cases. If this is not the case, go to the appropriate settings and select CamTwist as video source. I have tested this setup with Google Meet, Microsoft Teams and Skype, and it currently works fine. With Zoom, however, there are problems with the version 4.6.11. For this reason, I have reinstalled the older version 4.6.8, with which it works. Zoom has been criticized a lot lately because of several security flaws. Here you have to decide what is more important for you. But it is also possible that CamTwist will be recognized in a later version. The whole setup is of course not perfect, and compared to a normal webcam, it seems complicated. I also noticed that there can be a very small delay in the image. But depending on your needs, it might be a useful solution. And that's it for today. If the video was interesting for you, give me a like as feedback, and see you next time!